Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome to Peppy Pronunciation 5. My name is Steve Ford, and today we are going to continue studying some of the O sounds that I was talking about in Peppy Pronunciation 4. So let's go. Yes, the famous O sounds, there are so many. My students over the years have always asked me, Steve, are there any spelling rules that can help me to learn English pronunciation better? Unfortunately, there seem to be more exceptions than rules. Even native speakers have a lot of difficulty spelling. Many depend on Google and their word processor to correct their spelling mistakes for them. It's that difficult. Spelling in English works as well as a screen door on a submarine. You've got something there, but something is always going wrong. Something is always penetrating. So it doesn't work that well most of the time. It has a lot to do with different languages which mixed with English, and also spelling rules trying to preserve old English, even up until today. For example, we have the word doubt. That's an OU sound. That's a sound I'm going to be talking about today, in fact. Doubt comes from a combination of words. It comes from dubitare, which is Latin. It also comes from douté, which is French. So when you take dubitare and douté and you put them together, you have doubt. So they have kept the B, but you will never see somebody saying doubt. No, it doesn't exist. Should they drop the B? Yeah, they probably should. But they haven't, because they've preserved the spelling rules. They've preserved history in that one word. So the new ones that we're going to listen to are For example, book, could, would, should. That's a sound. And you can see on your screen the way that I'm writing that. Last time I talked about sound. Remember I said when you go to the doctor and it sounds like when he asks you to stick out your tongue and say, aw, problem. Well, we have a shorter variation of that, and that's So it's basically the same sound as aw, but it's a little shorter, You want to cut it halfway, So let's take an example. You could say tough. That guy's really tough. You don't say tough, you say tough. So you can compare the two sounds there. For example, thought, that's an aw sound, and tough, that's also an aw sound, but it's a lot shorter, tough. So that's my second new sound for today. My last O sound for today is ew. When you see something disgusting, something that is repugnant. Many times in English we say, ew, oh, it's disgusting, ew. That's the sound that you want to make for this O sound, ew. Smooth is an example. We don't say smooth, we say smooth. So those are our three sounds, so let's try to practice them with some examples.
Hello, hello, hello! Welcome to your Peppy Pronunciation Workout. Yes, the song we're going to sing today is to help with your pronunciation. Sing an ooh. One more time. Ooh. Very good, well done. You can give yourself a pat on the back for that one. So let's try some basic to intermediate practice on the count of 1, 2, 3, 4. Look, look, look. Luck, luck, luck. Luke, Luke, Luke. Very good, well done. You can give yourself a pat on the back for that one. Now, for all of you students who are more advanced, let's try something more challenging. Now, to do this next advanced exercise, let's change the tempo. That's better. On the count of 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, Luke, did you have any luck with that lock? Hey, Luke, did you have any luck with that lock? One more time. Hey, Luke, did you have any luck with that lock? Hey, Luke, did you have any luck with that lock? That is your peppy pronunciation workout for today. Good job.
Okay, a classic example is from Peppy 17, where I talk about the different T-H-O-U-G-H variations. Many of those words look similar, but when you pronounce them, they're totally different. So we're going to apply those O-U-G-H sounds to help you with the pronunciation of the new examples that I've given you today. So let's start with the first one. This first word is meticulous in detail. It's very high level. I know I usually start at the intermediate level first, but to follow the words, I'm starting with an advanced one first. Thorough. Thorough. That first O sound is my first O sound that I was talking about. That's a U sound. Th, thorough. That's the same U sound as in book, should, would. Th, thorough. So if you compare that to the O sound that I mentioned last lesson, you can see two different O sounds in the same word. Thorough, thorough.
You
can make some music out of it. Maybe I'll try something as I am putting this video together. My next example is tough. This is a really tough exercise. Contrast tough with thought. Tough, thought. So those are very similar. This is very advanced, but the first example is shorter. Tough, it cuts off. Thought, it's a longer thought. My last sound example, the new one for today, remember I was talking about when you're disgusted, something is repugnant and you say, ew. That's the sound that you want to say, ew, for through. So you can think about that, those three sounds.
One common mistake made by many English learners.
My last classic error that a lot of students make is the difference between soup and soap. Soup, soap. I've heard many students who we're traveling in an English-speaking country. They go to the supermarket and they want to buy some soup, but they say soap. Soup, soap. Okay, so repeat after me. Though grow no soap. Once again, though grow no soap. Contrast that with through grew new soup. Very good. We're doing some excellent work here. Keep it up and you can give yourself that pat on the back. Try these sounds. This is the ah sound. Thought, taught, bought. Tut, tut, but. And for the advanced students, tut, tot, tut, tot. So let's try it again. Tut, tot, tut, tot. Great. Good work, advanced. We just have one more. Cunning, conning, cunning, conning. Once again, cunning, conning, cunning, conning. So you can try and practice those. You can play the video again to get a better workout, especially with those advanced examples. I am now going to post a quiz for you so that you can try and identify the different sounds that I have taught you today. This is an overall review of everything that we've learned from Peppy Pronunciation 4 and 5. I really enjoy teaching you today, taking all of my teaching experience and trying to give it to you in the shortest way possible. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Okay, so here is a basic review for the first six sounds that we've learned in Pepe pronunciation 4 and 5. So I will show you the picture and you can try and say the sound after I will give you the answer. So let's try the first one. Ah, bot. But. Ew. Boot. Oh. Boat. Ow. Bout. Book. Did you take a lock? What a look. She doesn't know what bout means. But I thought you bought some already. I thought the test wasn't that tough, though. Luck, luck, look. Luke, Luke, look. Look, Luke, luck. Lock, lock, lock. Look, look, look.